How do you paint a picture? Using only words. How do you convey the magic of sport? With no moving images. How do you put people on the edge of their seats when there's nothing to look at? Radio has always had a powerful voice in bringing iconic moments from the Olympic Games to the world, elevating the imagination of the listener.
Millions and millions of people, that's their main communication with the Olympic Games. And it reaches everywhere, in the outskirts of Australia to northern Siberia to any part of the world you want to go. Radio will be there.
Radio creates a more intimate, emotional environment. You can pay attention, you can follow it all by yourself without being too much distracted from the environment.
345.7, an absolutely fantastic performance!
A great sports radio commentator can just bring sport to life in a way that very little else can.
10 metres now, Brooks in front, it could be Australia's goal!
We may be living in a supremely visual society, but radio is still one of the fastest and most emotional mediums out there.
Vous écoutez RMC, il est 9h, tout de suite les informations.
One of the unique aspects of radio is the scope and immediacy of its coverage. Here at Pyeongchang 2018, despite having only two commentary positions, Czech radio is able to broadcast from virtually all venues, thanks to today's mobile technology.
We have here for the first time broadcast from this Olympics on internet and DAB radio. We are 24 hours on air. If you see the story, you can get these voices immediately to the radio. It can be broadcast very quickly. 20 years ago, you need half an hour to get your story to the Prague. Now it's seconds. It's incredible. You just switch your phone on, dial it, and it's on air.
Druhé zlato v Pyeongchangu.
One of the big demands of radio is delivering hours of content that's relevant and engaging.
It was windy. The giant slalom was cancelled. So we had 6 hours of nothing live. So then we had to take maybe one or two documentaries, new guests, be creative to produce interesting radio. But they are really good at that. Yeah, improvise.
The challenge is to basically cover everything. Because when you see something, you have to say it immediately, because otherwise the listener will be waiting and they will hear that something is happening, but you are not saying what is happening.
We try to interact as much as we can with the audience in different social media platforms and try to get in contact with the audience, sending pictures, send happy regards to the successful athletes and so on.
Radio also has an inherent intimacy. It allows the narrative to go beyond the play-by-play commentary and explore the human stories behind the sport.
Earlier today, I actually sent back a radio piece for ABC in Australia, and it was a 5-minute audio postcard. And essentially, I told the story of three people that I'd met here, none of them gold medalists, but their stories actually tell what the Olympics is all about.
At each Olympic Games, there are moments that make you stop and think. The first was meeting...
I can record an interview and I can email it straight back and they can put it on air almost immediately. I can edit on my phone. I mean, it's just incredible. You can go to an event now, edit on the bus, and by the time you get back to the media centre, you've already sent it through. It's probably already been played 1,000 times.
Peter says, as a kid, he was always the smallest, the skinniest, the slowest. But he's now a 2-time Olympian, and if he can, then so can they. This is Tracy Holmes in Pyeongchang for The Ticket.
French radio station RMC is ready to transmit live to Paris on primetime. Hopes are high for another gold for France in the biathlon.
We have a 2 hours dedicated program between 1 p.m. and 3 p.m. on the Paris time. This is the biggest competition for us, full coverage of 2 hours, and to have the reaction on live with Martin Fourcade.
Martin Fourcade is with Eric.
Bien sûr, c'est une déception. On avait vraiment une place à jouer sur ce podium-là.
The multiple feeds from the commentary box, the mixed zone, and the experts in the studio means that the live coverage can be supported by in-depth analysis.
I think radio has the time to explain to our listeners what is the most important. If it's the sports performance, if it's the character of the winner, for example, it is important on radio to tell a story about a man, a woman, or a performance, not only to show a picture or to show the video of the finish line or of the race, for example.
German radio station ARD is one of the biggest radio stations at the Games. Theirs is a different model, transmitting the action and passion of the Games to almost 60 different stations around Germany.
It's a compact and comprehensive way to bring this like a package to your listeners, either live or download as a podcast via the new audio platforms, let's say, Google Home or Amazon Alexa. We had the quarterfinal in men's ice hockey, Sweden versus Germany. The sudden-death goal of the German player was questioned by the video assist. And then everybody was waiting for his decision.
Zeig in die Mitte, dann steht Deutschland im Halbfinale. Was sagt er? Ja! Wir haben ein gut goal! Wir haben ein gutes Tor! Ein wunderbares
Tor! Our commentator was live on air. All the tension, all the emotion of the reporter, it was a brilliant, it was an iconic radio moment.
As a host broadcaster for the Games, OBS has the responsibility to not only deliver the coverage for television and digital, but also for radio. But there are still key responsibilities that the organizing committee has, beyond providing fast connectivity, that can enhance the radio coverage of the Games.
The committee, in a sense, is responsible in delivering the audio reality of an event. And there, a lot of work needs to be done. We are extremely in favor of a very animated crowd, of a very animated spectators within an Olympic competition. But this should not be done to the detriment of audio for commentators or audio for television. And today, with the technology that exists, this is very, very possible.
It's still powerful today because podcasting is exploding. And that's just another name for radio, essentially. A podcast is a radio program. And that's phenomenal because I can speak to people in every country, in every place. And you get a whole different range of ideas and opinions and, you know, it brings the world together.
Radio will change, the way it's delivered changes, but it will always be there. Radio is still my big love, and I believe in the unique emotional capacity of radio.